गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. इन आवर लास्ट क्लास आई गिवन दिस नोट दैट इज वेलोसिटी ऑफ लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल और इलास्टिक वेव इन ए फ्लूइड सपोज इन द गैस. सो दिस इज सपोज ए सिलेंडर इन विच गैस पार्टिकल्स आर प्रेजेंट, गैस मॉलिक्यूल्स आर प्रेजेंट. सो इफ ए साउंड वेव इज मूविंग from left to right, then somewhere we are going to get large number of molecules and somewhere we are going to get less number of molecules. That means this part is called as a compression of the molecule and this part is the rarefaction of these molecules. So R means rarefaction, C means compression, and here N is stands for normal density or normal occurrence of the molecules without flow of any sound. So here we can understand one thing, that whenever a sound wave is moving from left to right, the normal density, so you can observe here, this is the normal density of the particle throughout this cylinder is going to be changed in this scenario. Means at a particular point we can get large number of molecules or density, and its side by we are going to get less number of molecules or particle called as rare fraction. So same thing it has been written, the example of longitudinal or elastic wave is sound wave. Let a sound wave is propagating in the medium as shown in the figure, that is from left to right. Here it is the arrow mark. Therefore we can found compression and rarefaction in the medium. This is the compression and this is the rarefaction. Let the wave is traveling from left to right, N be the region of normal density, denoted as rho. C and R are the region of compression and rarefaction. U rho and U dash rho dash be the velocity and density of the medium at A and C respectively. Here U is the velocity of the oscillation or wave at N, and U dash is the velocity of the sound at C point, and rho is the normal density of the medium. Rho dash is the density due to compression. तमें जो दिसे जो फिगर टा जी फाइल टा मुझे दे ही थिली गत थर का सही टा कुदर जो ऑब्जर्व करियो तो जानी परिवो जे की गोट्टे जागरे पार्टिकल को संख्या बा डेंसिटी बढ़ी जाउची, ता दीपट साइड रे पार्टिकल को संख्या कमी जाउची, ता माने जोठी बढ़ी जाउची सेटा होची कंप्रेशन, ता दीपट साइड रे साइडवाइज ऑफ दैट कंप्रेशन वी कैन गेट द रेयर फ्रैक्शन. एंड अनदर थिंग यू कैन ऑल्सो नोटिस दैट ऑल द पार्टिकल्स आर ऑक्सिलेटिंग इट्स मीन पोजिशन. ड्यू टू ऑक्सिलेशन we can perceive or we can get a wave is moving from left to right. से जो figure टा आउ थोड़े देखी कि तुम्हें observe करके जानी परिवो जे कि गोटे wave by energy transport ही जाऊची left to right की जत्तो बड़े the particles oscillating about its mean position. Let A is the area of the cross section. Let A. Now mass of the medium entering N in 1 second will be how much? Area of the cross section into length of the medium moved in 1 second into density of the medium. We know that density is equal to rho is equal to m by v. mass by volume, and therefore mass is equal to rho into V. So here V is nothing but area into length into rho, right? So that implies mass of medium entering N in 1 second. At this point, how much mass entering from left to right, that will be depends upon the area of the vellus, area of the that bar, and length in 1 second, how much distance the particle or the wave will be travel. That we considered, that we found that value, area of the cross section and length of the medium moved in 1 second, and then density, that is A, U and rho. Here rho means velocity of the medium at point N, at point N. So if the velocity is U, then the length in 1 second will be traveled as U, because we know that V is equal to how much? S by T. So S is equal to how much? V into T. So S, length in 1 second, if I am going to put T is equal to 1, then S is equal to V. Hence, length of the medium moved in 1 second can be written as U. Area of the cross section is A, density of the medium is rho at the point N. Likewise, we have to find out the mass. Similarly, mass of medium leaving C in 1 second, that means if mass is entering, some mass is entering at point N, then that much mass will be leaving at the point C. So mass of the medium at the point C will be how much? A, velocity in 1 second, and density of the medium at that point called as C. But average density of the medium remain constant. The average density should have to be constant throughout the medium. That implies mass of the medium at N will be the equal to the mass of the medium at C. So equating the both, A U rho is equal to A U dash rho dash is equal to M, that implies we can get U into rho is equal to U dash into rho dash. Let this is equation number 1. Since C is a compression region, but we know that at C point we can get large number of molecules as compared with N, as well as compared with the rare fraction. Therefore, obviously at point C, the density will be larger. That means rho dash should have to be greater than rho. So now if rho dash is greater than rho and U rho is equal to U dash rho dash, that 100% it will be, we can get that U, this U should have to be greater than U dash. Okay. Thus medium moves from N to C, it undergoes decrease in velocity and hence a loss of momentum takes place. These two lines is important to be understand. See, if you are going to be disturbed for these two lines, I am going to give you one example. Suppose these four are carom dots. These are carom dots. This is your striker. Okay. Whenever you have to be strike this striker to the first dot, then it will be move faster and it will be strike to second. Then second one will be strike to third one. Third one will be strike to fourth one. You just imagine when the striker will be strike to the first dot, then the momentum is transformed to the fourth dot. You just say that which dot will be move faster, 1 dot, first dot or fourth dot. Again I am going to ask that if this striker is striked first one, then this first one will be striked second, second to third, third to fourth. You just imagine when this striker is striked first one and the momentum is transformed to fourth one, which one will be moved with higher velocity, one or four? Obviously one, like that. Thus the medium as moving from N to C, it undergoes decrease in velocity and hence loss of momentum. So this side is your, this side is your N side and this side is your C side, N side, C side. So as the velocity or the wave moving from this to this, obviously at the starting point U will be higher velocity and then U dash will be less than the U. If we are going to measure here velocity, suppose U double dash will be decreased and less than that of the U dash. Okay, that means velocity is continuously decreasing as the wave moving towards the right. Got it? Then loss of momentum. How much the momentum is going to be lost? Initial momentum minus final momentum. Initial momentum was M into V minus final momentum. That is M into U dash. That means here both have mass is same. This mass is same, this mass is same. But its momentum is mass into U. This person's momentum is mass into U dash. So momentum is different. So how much momentum is different or how much it has been lost here as compared to this means mu m into mu dash minus m into mu dash. M into mu minus m into mu dash. Okay. Loss of momentum is result of pressure difference between C and N. The force due to their pressure difference produce a retardation of the medium. This is also important. So loss of momentum is result of pressure difference between C and N. If we are going to again analyze the figure, we can find whatever the pressure is here, because means here the pressure is depends upon the number of molecules, number of particles. So here as the particles is less as compared to this one, so pressure is here larger than this one. So obviously pressure, if difference, we can get the pressure difference. Obviously pressure is nothing but P is equal to force per unit area. Obviously force on this and this will be different. So due to pressure difference produce a retardation of the medium. We can get the force due to their pressure difference produce a retardation of the medium. So let P and P dash be the pressures of the medium in the region A and C respectively. Force due to the pressure difference will be how much, because we know that force is equal to pressure by area, and pressure is equal to how much, F into A. P is equal to F by A. P is equal to F by A. So that means F is equal to P into A. F is equal to P into A. But at point C, as number of molecules is larger than the point N, so P dash A is greater than that of the P A. So difference will be P dash A minus P A. According to Newton's second law, the so-called this one force will be the change in momentum. Change in force is equal to change in momentum. Change in momentum mu m u minus m u dash m into u minus u dash. So p minus p dash a is equal to a m. If I'll put instead of m like this, a u rho u minus u dash. that implies p dash minus p equal to a. So here you can also put a u dash rho dash, you can get the at the end the same answer, no problem. So m instead of m, here I put it the m u rho and this one m. If you are going to take u common, then u square rho 1 minus u dash by u. So that implies a got cancelled, u square rho is equal to p dash minus p by 1 minus u dash u. So we know that previous equation, we know that u rho is equal to u dash rho dash. So u dash by u is equal to rho by rho dash. So u dash instead of u dash by u, u dash by u, we can substitute rho by rho dash. But density is inverse proportional to the volume, because rho is equal to m by v. So volume and density both are inverse proportional. So hence rho by rho dash can be equal to v dash by v. So u square rho is equal to p dash minus p 1 minus v dash by v. So in this way we can found dp, p dash minus p is dp, v minus v dash by v or dv by v. So this dp is nothing but the increase in pressure in compression region. Dv is the corresponding decrease in volume, corresponding decrease in volume. So dp is nothing but change in force per unit area, that is called the stress p. We know that p is equal to force per a, force by area. If a is equal to 1, then p is equal to f, then force per unit area is called the pressure. So likewise dp will be the change in force per unit area, that is nothing but called the stress. Dv by v is called the volume strain, change in volume, original volume. So u square rho is equal to how much stress by volume strain is equal to, that is E, which is nothing but called as Bok modulus of the medium, or it is also called as the coefficient of elasticity of the medium or Bok modulus. So that implies u equal to Bok modulus by density of the medium. So this is the relation or velocity of a longitudinal wave in a specific medium. So if the medium will be changed, its Bok modulus will be changed and corresponding velocity will be changed. This relations also nothing but called as Newton's formula. Okay, so today is this much. You watch it and at the time also you have to check your note. Maybe you have been written incorrectly somewhere, that you have to correct. Okay, thank you.